Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you my Whole Foods Amazon delivery. I've been doing a lot of delivery lately because I'm just busy and it's easier. So I want to share it with you. I want to show you all the things that I got from the store that is going to help you on your healing journey if you add these foods to your lifestyle. Now, the foods that I bought is probably about a week's worth of food for most of what I got. Some of the things will last a little bit longer, but you'll see a lot of greens. And because it's winter time and the fruit is kind of going out of season, I'm increasing my greens. Although I eat greens all the time, we need greens in order to heal. The more greens, the better. So watch what I buy and mimic it. I'm going to be sharing more recipes with you so you can learn how to use the produce that I actually purchase in your own lifestyle. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Chelsea Knudsen. I'm a certified holistic health coach, certified life coach, and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female-related issues using food as medicine. If you want to learn how to work with me, there's a link down in the description box below this video. Also, if you're new here, welcome. Thank you for joining me. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you like what you see, and please don't forget that notification bell so you never miss an episode. So let's go into the kitchen and let me show you what I got from my Whole Foods grocery haul via Amazon. All right, y'all. See you in a minute. So here's my bags. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 bags. These groceries cost me like $140 for this stuff. Some of it was high ticket, and some of it, like I said, will last a long period of time. Don't feel like you have to buy things that cost a lot of money, because if you don't have it to spend, don't buy it. You can find cheaper versions or just leave it out. I just happen to spend my money on my food. I don't have a lot of designer bags, designer shoes, all that stuff. So I use my money for my health. But you do what you can afford. Don't let any of this make you feel bad if you can't afford it. Eat what you can afford. Okay, ladies, here are my foods I purchased from the Whole Foods in my area. So let me just go through each thing. So of course I've got some jalapenos because my husband likes hot salads, and then occasionally I will put them on salads. Lemons, I have plenty of lemons because they add vitamin C to smoothies and juices, and they also are a staple for my homemade salad dressings. I use at least one lemon a day in my salad dressings. Also limes, I love just how the taste of lime just makes a salad, all the flavors come together. I put lime on my salads regardless if I make a salad dressing or not. I don't know why I do that. I just started doing it, and I think I got that from one of my clients and friends now. That does that often, and it is a game changer for salads for me. Okay, now I've got some vine ripened tomatoes. It's just 3. That's not gonna last very long, but I have some cherry tomatoes in the refrigerator that I'll pair with that this week. And I'll probably have to go to the store just to get some staple things that I run out of, potentially. Here's some small avocados, which I love in all my salads. There's a red onion, which I put in all my salads. Carrots, just to add some color and some texture to salads. Blueberries. I use blueberries if I make a smoothie. I'm sorry, not a smoothie bowl, but a fruit bowl. And I also add them to my salads. I do the same thing with the strawberries as well. And if you notice that these strawberries and blueberries are not organic. I do buy organic strawberries and blueberries, but I couldn't get them. They didn't have them at Whole Foods. So guess what? I went with the conventional ones, and I will just wash them, pray over them, and eat them. All right, so what I've got here is This is ketchup. This is a good quality ketchup. It has no sugar, no craziness in it. So if you make like butternut squash, French fries or something, and you want to dip your fries in ketchup, this is a good one to buy. Of course, I've got pepperoncini. My husband loves pepperoncinis in all of his salads, and he likes the green olives as well. So we got that. And sometimes I put that in there, it just depends. You don't want to overdo it on olives though, because they are high in fat and they can be a trigger food for some people. So you want to watch what kind of olives you buy. You want to buy good quality olives, and you want to have a serving of olives a day, not like the whole jar. And then chopped pecans. I prefer the whole pecans, but they were like $10 and I just couldn't do it today. And these were the chopped ones, and they were like $5 or something like that. So I chose those. Got some pumpkin seeds to put on my salads. All of these are salad toppers for me. Also, I don't really eat big bowls of bean soup anymore. My body doesn't really love it, but what I do is I will put beans in a vegetable soup that is mostly vegetables, but in the soup, I mean, the beans are like a condiment, but mostly I don't even really eat soup that much anymore. What I'll do is I'll just put like a quarter to a half a cup of beans on top of my salad. That's what I'll do when I eat beans. And butter beans happen to be my favorite beans. And this Eaten Organic butter beans is a very good quality bean. And it tastes really good. Lemon balm tea. I love lemon balm tea. It's good for the reproductive system. So if this is something that you would like to add, it is really, really good. I mean, good. Like, it helps the whole body, literally. Let's see, what do we have now? I have my stash of bananas. And when you buy from Whole Foods online, there's only so many bananas they'll let you buy. So I would have bought like 6 bunches just so that I could put them on my counter and let them ripen so that I can put them in the freezer for smoothies, because I use bananas in just about every smoothie I make. And here's my sprouts. I've got kale sprouts, arugula sprouts, and sunflower sprouts. I add these to my salad. You can even put them in your smoothies. These sprouts are filled with minerals. Women with reproductive issues are deficient in a lot of minerals that don't show up on tests. But the minerals in the greens is the thing that makes you, that helps you to heal. Now, the sprouts have a big punch of minerals because they are babies, and when they're babies, that's when they're the most loaded. So if you can start adding, you know, a handful of sprouts to your smoothies, you can even put the whole box in your smoothie, or just add some sprouts every single day. So if you can get sprouts into your diet every single day, that's wonderful. You can buy them from the store. Sometimes in certain stores, they're very expensive. To me, these were expensive. They were $4 a box, $4 or $5 a box, depending on which one they are. But you could also grow your own sprouts. I did a video teaching you how to grow sprouts in a jar at home very cheaply. I will link the video right here. But if you don't have time for that, you can just buy some sprouts and do it. I mean, put them in your food, because they're gonna help you heal. Sprouts, sprouts, sprouts. Eat sprouts. They help your skin, they help your nails, they help your hair. I mean, like, I can't say enough good things about them. Next, I've got some mixed greens. My husband likes this for salad. I don't really like it for salad. I will eat it, but it's not my favorite. But the thing about the spring mix that's wonderful is the fact that it's, you don't have to wash it. You don't have to do anything with it. All you have to do is grab it and put it in a bowl and go. So, you know, that's the advantage to having the mixed greens. I mean, the spring mix. Okay, so this is a new favorite of mine, aloe vera. Aloe vera, frozen aloe vera. I put this in every last one of my smoothies, unless I forget. Sometimes I forget, but one of the things I found about this is is not only good for your skin, hair, nails, all that stuff, but it's also good for healing the digestive tract. I try to put a half to a cup of this aloe vera in my smoothies every single day that I have a smoothie. And I have noticed a difference in my digestion. You may not notice it right away if you're not in tune with your body, but if you are in tune with your body, this will, you'll notice it. It is worth it. And I've tried to purchase the fresh ones, and I do it from time to time, but sometimes I forget. Sometimes I'm busy and I don't feel like laying it. And this has just been a better option for me. I got this, of course, from Whole Foods. This is a new product from this particular company, and it's quite expensive. Literally, it's about $5 or $6 for one bag, and it's just a small bag. And I think it has 2.5 servings. And I think the serving size is, let's see, the serving size is a half a cup. So, am I looking at that right? I don't have any glasses on, y'all. Sorry. Yeah, half a cup. So there's 2.5 servings for a bag. So you gotta weigh that out for yourself. Maybe it's less expensive for you to buy the whole leaf, and maybe you'll buy that, or you can buy aloe powder to add to your smoothies as well. The next thing that I always use in my salad lately is baby arugula. I absolutely love it in my salads. I don't know why. It just adds a different depth of flavor to salads, as most lettuces are neutral. And arugula is peppery and a little bit bitter and spicy. So I think that addition is just adding some interest to my salad. But in addition to that, arugula, because of the bitter herb of it, it helps to stimulate your liver into functioning properly. So helping the cleansing process, creating bile, things like that. So you always wanna see if you can eat something bitter. All right, did I get, okay, I've got some cucumbers here, and then I've got one zucchini. After I placed my order last night, I was kicking myself because I wanted to make like the zucchini spiralized dish, and one zucchini is not gonna be enough for anybody, so. Anyway, so here I have my red leaf lettuce. Right now, I'm loving romaine, red leaf, and green leaf lettuce. So this is what I got for this week. I got two heads here, and of course I'm adding cilantro to every salad. I've been talking to you about it, and I think it's because it adds flavor. And if you don't like cilantro, you can use Italian parsley. It will add flavor as well. So right here, I've got two boxes of baby spinach for my smoothies. Most days I put one box of spinach in the blender and some fruit and whatever else I'm putting in there and blend it up and drink the whole blender full of smoothie. That's healing. And the other thing I have here is baby kale. And they didn't give me the best one. You see that little yellow one right there? That's the difference between going to the store and doing it yourself. But most of the time they do a little good job. The rest of it, it looks pretty good. It's just that little section, but I've got two boxes there. But there you have it. This is what I bought from the store. I hope this has been helpful for you in buying the foods that you're going to need to help you on your healing journey. And a lot of people will say, Chelsea, is that all you eat is salads? Yeah, these days, yes, I eat salads, and that's what my body craves. And when you start eating them is what your body will crave, and you'll start forgetting about all that old food that got you sick in the first place, and you will want to eat healthy, wholesome foods, and you will break out of food addiction. Most people are addicted to food, but they don't want to admit it, or they don't understand that they are. If you can't go without some of that old food, without freaking out, then you are addicted to food. And I mean, even just a little bit of freaking out, that's food addiction. So anyway, ladies, thank you so much for watching. I'm so glad you got to join me on this journey of seeing what I've been getting from Amazon Whole Foods delivery, because it really is a blessing to be able to show you what I am putting in my body that helps me to function at a high level and helps my body to continue the healing process. And if no one told you today that they love you, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much,
and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.